Correct.
Hey guys, I'm Rohit, and I'm part of the technology team of Make a Difference, and today I'll be talking about search engine optimization. So, in today's talk, I'll be covering what SEO is and why we do SEO, search engine optimization, and how does search engine work, and search engine marketing and why we should do this, and to for the next step of how we can make a website search engine friendly or using development, and talk about what I'm going to cover the further topics in the next competency days also. Alright, so SEO, what is it? Has anyone heard of it before? Alright, so search engine optimization is a discipline where we use to make sure our website gets more visibility or more traction, right? And SEO encompasses of both the technical and creative skills which we use to build that visibility upon a website. Now, why does a website need SEO? So in most cases, the website traffic is driven by the biggest commercial search engines such as Google, Bing or Yahoo. Even though social media can also drive traffic to our website, but at the same time, majority of users on the internet use the search engines or like Google, Bing or Yahoo to reach websites. Now, before we go into how to analyze search engine optimization and how to do search engine optimization, we need to understand what search engines really do. Now, search engines basically have two major operations, which is crawling and indexing into file and providing answers to the user's result based on relevance and ranking. Alright, let's look at crawling and indexing first. So, crawling and indexing, imagine the World Wide Web, WWW, as a metro rail network. And in the network, for us to reach every stop, we need to go through all the stops using the rail to find every stop. Similarly, we use websites, the search engines or the crawlers use the links to reach every stop, which could be our web pages, through the search engine, and then they use the same technology to list down on the web pages and capture the data in various massive databases. And this allows so crawlers are automated robots on website which crawl through the website, or literally crawl through the website, the word crawl through the website, to find all the web pages and the relevant information in the pages. Now, search engines are basically answering machines also. Whatever question we ask, search engine provides an answer. And the answer is primarily done two major steps. Firstly, it returns the results which are relevant for us and for whatever the keyword is being searched for. And secondly, it gives us a response based on the popularity and the relevance of the content which is there. Right? Now, since we're talking about popularity and relevance, that is again driven by ranking factors in SEO. So there are a few factors. There are over 200 factors which are listed by Google in the Google's search engine algorithm. But at the same time, we can't really cover everything here, so I'll probably take you through top 3-4 of them. So the first one is content. So content is one of the most important factors to search, because that is exactly what is getting displayed in the search engine results. And in recent time, earlier we used to look at only keywords to search, but now we're looking at more of a natural language content which gives results to display our search results. Right. Next is backlinks. So backlinks are links which can drive through our website. So again, linking back to the content part, the more strong our content is, it makes the third parties or the users grasp our content that has reference link to their website. Basically, which means if we have more diversity of website which is driving their traffic to us using their links, we'll have more or better ranking facilities. Better ranking. Mobile first UI. So all of us know that the world is now shifting completely from a laptop or a computer-driven atmosphere to mobile-friendly atmosphere. Even the Google search algorithm has changed drastically in the last 2-3 years, where they're primarily looking at mobile first, like not even mobile friendly, but mobile first, because that's what the traffic is getting diverted primarily through. So they're looking, the crawlers are also moving more into the mobile friendly websites and getting content. At the same time, we know that our mad website at the first place is not mobile responsive. So that's one of the biggest steps we're gonna take in the next 1 year also, right? And mobile friendliness is now a norm, like it's just unacceptable for the fact that we don't have a mobile friendly website, because again, as I said before, we have to think mobile first, not mobile friendly. Alright, there are a few technical factors like, you know, encryption, for example. If you see, a lot of websites have HTTPS instead of HTTP, which is a more secure server. And it's proven that from the search algorithms that the one website with HTTPS security have more ranking or more visibility in the search atmosphere. And there are other factors like, you know, heading tags. So we have to make sure that the relevant information is placed as a header, because from a hierarchy of content, the website search crawlers first go to the title of website, then to the main headers, then the links, and eventually towards the end only it reaches to something like a normal textual content on the website. So we have to focus on the headers, make sure the relevant information are crisp and concise and presented in a header format. Third one is anchor text. So anchor text, basically, if you see, when you link a document, you can rename the links, right? For example, if I've written a text called ABC, it can direct to anything. So we have to make sure that the title of the relevant, the linking text or the anchor text should be relevant to what the content is leading towards also, right? And yeah, and the next again is website title. You have to make sure that the title is informative enough for the website, for the crawlers to search and make sense out of it. Right, so we'll quickly look into search engine marketing and why. And so it's just a very short topic at this point. So one of the important aspects of SEO is also to make sure the robots understand what your website is about. Even though technology has moved a lot fast, but it's not the same for humans to understand at the same, and like a website to understand, for a crawler to understand what a website is like. But we have to put in effort, we have to make sure the content is readable enough to, for the crawlers also to understand what a search engine, what a website information should be conveyed to the web. Now, we'll now move to search engine friendly design. So, again, as I said, the website, the way a website looks to us is not the way it looks to crawlers or spiders, right? And it the search engine development covers technical aspects of how we should create or place text in the website so that it's similar to a human visitor and a crawler. And following up, I'll just go through a few methods which we can use to make sure the search engine is easily searchable. The website is easily searchable by the search engine, sorry. Now, indexable content. So if you look at it, the website, which this is a mad website, and this is the way it looks to us, like with all the graphics in it and stuff like that. But at the same time, on a Google cache or a Google cache search engine, it looks something like it's only text. So the essential idea is that the majority of information is passed to the search engine using text. Things like images, flash files, or Java applet files are normally ignored by the crawlers, even no matter how much technology has grown. Primary focus is still on the text. So we have to make sure that, you know, the text has relevant information and stuff to cover this thing. So I think there are a few things which you can use to make sure the text in the website is put, is able to convey the information. So provide alt tags for images. So just to give you context, alt tags are tags which we use in website development against images to ensure that an image displays a text. Even if the image doesn't get loaded in the website, there's some text which is relevant to the image which gets popped up. So it should be made a manual, it should be compulsory for us to put the image, what the image is, in a textual format, because it's easier for the Google for the search engine to search for it. Right. Next is supplement flash and Java links with text on it. Very simple. So a lot of us seen, like, in earlier websites, a lot of websites were made using flash. Like speed test was earlier made using flash. There are a lot of flash games. So the information is not really diggable from a search engine crawler point of view. So we have to make sure that we have to supplement the information using text. Third is transcribing videos. Videos are one of the major important. At least in MAD, we use videos as a medium to convey a lot of information. But at the same time, videos are not something which, applications like YouTube, it's easy because they already have a transcribing document where they go to the video and grab the text and show it. But if you want to put a video in a website, you have to make sure it's transcribed or some form of text in the website's code, which makes it easier for the search engines to search for it. Okay, the next part is crawlable link structures. So, as I mentioned earlier, the whole crawling exercise happens because of interlinking website. A crawler basically goes through all multiple billions of interlinked documents to find pages and stuff. If seen them, if there's a document in a website which is not really found, which is not really linked to any other documents, probably called an orphan document, then it'd be hard for the document to pop up in any of the results. So this is an example, basically. If you see, the document B and E are linked to the home page, right? And no matter how much information how important information C and D might cover. It might not be visible for the search engine because it's not really linked to any document. It's just like as an option and a file which is not really accessible to the Google. In fact, for Google, the file might not exist in the first place. The great content, the page might have great content, good keyword targeting and smart marketing, but it doesn't really right? Next is keyword usage. Then again, words play an important role in how we define our website and search engine. So keywords are also used importantly to target our website in the link. In fact, textual information is another major information which is again used by the crawlers to find data, right? As I mentioned before. And all the crawlers, when they go through the website, multiple pages of the website, they don't just like grasp everything in one single database, but at the same time they segregate the information then and there and put categories in similar smaller millions of databases. If you see that, you know, if I search for something like dog, a keyword called dog, there's a table, there's a database that exists for dog which has all relevant searches based on the keyword dog, and then based on that is when the ranking is done based on the relevance and popularity of content, and then only when we get the result. And all of this happens in fractions of seconds. I'm sure if you see in Google, when you search in Google, it shows that like there's some 12 million results in 0.012 seconds kind of thing. And it's primarily possible because of their multiple databases and multiple bots get working on getting the data, and then the collision happens. Right, title tags. Title tags are the titles that we see on website. In Make a Difference website, we see when we open the browser, the one come from the browser map is called the title, like which comes as Mad Make a Difference, right? And we have to make sure that the title is relevant of what the content is. Again, meta tags. Meta tags are usually descriptive text that we use in our websites. So it's not really visible to an outsider, but it's like meta information which has every HTML file which is stored in the website. Now this information primarily is a description field that we have. So whenever we search for something, the description that we see is primarily fetched from meta. If there's no meta, it just randomly fetches information. For example, if you just see succession planning and make a difference, this is the meta that I had made the website. So I remember the meta tag which is there was exactly what came in the search result. At the same time, for our main website, there was no particular meta tag involved, so we just randomly put any information which you could find from the textual content and put it this way, which is doesn't really say anything about what Matt does, right? So that brings us, I know it's a very short talk, it brings me to the end of the topic. There's a lot more for me to study and implement also, so in the next competency topic, I'll be covering things like keyword research, basically understanding what kind of keywords should be used, because there's a thing called keyword abuse also, which is very common in a lot of websites end up doing, and it just loses value. Right? There's a way to place keywords. There's the recommended number of words, like times you should use a keyword in the website. Next is how usability experience and content affects ranking. Usability experience, I had given a talk on this before, twice before. So usability is around how to make the websites more usable and stuff. Make anything more usable. And how it affects content and ranking. SEO tools, what are the tools that we can use to implement better search engine optimization, and what are algorithms that we can use and such thing. And what I'll be doing is probably to understand, try to implement the same in Mad website and try to track success for the same. So yeah, that's about it. Yes.